match. CDP, get kinetic. Hostile UAV spotted.
Sniper!
Hostile counter UAV above. Radar is down. Be advised. Hostile care package overhead. Hostile UAV above. Hostile UAV spotted. Be advised, hostile servers inbound.
Servers, hit it.
Hostile Guardian in your AO. Hostile UAV above. Hostile care package overhead.
Frag!
Be advised, hostile lightning strike targeting active. Hostile lightning strike inbound.
Decent, not fresh meat.
Thank you. am Dolos, mistress of deception and
trickery. All that remains is your sacrifice.
You are more powerful than he.
Humanity has outstayed its welcome. The dead shall inherit the earth.
Listen to the sound of my voice. Can you hear me?
Who's there? I can't see you.
My name is Dr. Salim. We've met before.
Dr. Salim? Where am I?
You have fallen between the world of the living and the dead. The void.
It started at Coalescence Singapore in 2070. 10 years after the disaster. After virus 6115 began its spread. After the dead began to walk the earth. We'd lost comms with John Taylor's squad, another undead extermination team. Dead killers, we were called. We should have known that the ASP wasn't planted. If we were gonna bring it down, we'd need to disable his shield and find a rocket launcher. Hendrix had a bad feeling about this. He wasn't the only one. I knew we shouldn't be there. Coalescence. Enhance yourself for a better tomorrow. They'd been the forefront of technology, always wanting to improve the individual, the future of you.
What happened? What went wrong?
The Coalescence disaster happened. Virus 6115 spread throughout Singapore and strains popped up all over the world. Governments built these quarantine zones to house the undead. A way for the populace to ignore what was happening. 10 years on, and it had worked. We put it out of mind. Ignorance was bliss.
What was so special about this operation?
It was supposed to be by the books. 5 years after our cybernetic augmentations, Hendrix and I were a well-oiled machine. Quarantine sweeps, recon, search and rescue. It's just what dead killers do. But we'd never been sent after one of our own before. John Taylor's systems had gone quiet. With our direct neural interface, we're hardwired into Winslow Accord servers. Observation knew if you were dead or alive. For Taylor to be neither, that was unusual. We located an EMF source and uploaded it to Central. It was a 54 immortal audio log, detailing unusual activity coming from the server room at the lowest level of the building. It couldn't have been more than a week old. Probably why Taylor's team had been sent to investigate. Hendricks activated a recon drone to scan for life. We picked up a signal coming from far below. As we stood there in the atrium, I felt like Alice. And we were about to jump down the rabbit hole. Our drone picked up activity ahead. We should have known we weren't alone down here. When man fled the virus, they left behind thousands of active robots. Machinery abandoned with one directive: kill the dead. Years later, they're still killing. But with decrepit programming, somehow humans had been added to their kill list, indistinguishable from our brainless counterparts. The strange behavior was observed in multiple quarantine zones. Another nuisance for us to deal with while on recon. We moved on. We reached the silo's floor, but the signal came from lower still, below coalescence.
Yeah!
Did you have any inkling of what waited for you?
No. In hindsight, we should have put it together. But the fact of the matter, that day was supposed to be like any other.
What did you find below Coalescence?
A CIA black project. Project Corvus. Unknown to the world, and unknown to most people in the know. As off the record as it got. A redacted footnote in Langley's history book. Part of me wishes we just turned back.
Why?
It would have been easier. For me. For Hendrix. For the world.
Is it such a bad thing to want to be blissfully ignorant in the face of daunting adversity?
We didn't have a choice.
Those who find fate thrust upon them rarely do.
Thank you.
the human testing lab. What awaited you there?
We found the truth, the cause of the disaster.
You are certain of this?
We didn't have the full picture, not yet. But this was the source. We knew coalescence was where the virus originated, but residue of 6115 in the air left no doubt. This was where it all began. When the disaster happened, hundreds of thousands died instantly. And they were the lucky ones. Because when the rest of Singapore inhaled 6115, they changed. From the living into the living dead. These test subjects, they were linked together, connected with a direct neural interface. Their minds hardwired into the central server. Hendrix didn't like what he saw. You knew something was wrong. The same tech in our own heads made us what we were. It was down here in this room. We didn't know what happened, but the data didn't lie. Man did what man always does, playing God and fucking everything up. We, the CIA, man, we created these things. We changed the world.
How do you mean, change the world?
The Winslow Accord and the Common Defense Pact. We'd been engaged in a Cold War for nearly a decade. 6115 changed that. When the dead walked among us, we set aside our differences. For all of your conflicts, you and your enemy had two things in common. You're both human, and you both want to stay that way.
Was this the source of the signal?
No, but it looked like Taylor had come through. Our answers were still further down.
When you found the server room, did you have any idea what you would uncover?
We couldn't have known. What we found was... We found Sebastian Diaz. One of Taylor's. Another dead killer. Our friend. He'd linked himself to the CIA server, connected directly with the Winslow Accord systems. He was deactivating defenses for the undead quarantine zones all over the world. The massive walls containing the spread, keeping us from the undead. Deactivating the defenses would let the flesh-eating hordes loose upon the living. It would end humanity. We had to stop him. The only way to stop him now was by destroying the server.
Yeah!
You killed him. Your friend.
He left us no choice. Hendrix wasn't happy and let Diaz know that. He'd unleashed the dead upon the world. Hendrix knew what he had to do.
You needed to find out what he knew. What he knew about Taylor.
Interfacing with Diaz and accessing his memories was the only way to find him.
Knowing what you know about DNI, interfacing would surely kill him.
That didn't matter. We had to know. Had I known what it would do to Hendrix. From the interface, Hendrix learned Taylor was trying to get out of Singapore. There wouldn't be much time before we'd be too late.
Tell me about the name. The name Hendrix learned.
The name. Deimos. The demigod of dread and terror. Hendrix, myself, we had no idea what it meant, but Taylor's team was obsessed with it. But more importantly, we learned our arrival on site wasn't a secret. We had company. Go Julan, leader of the 54 Immortals. The Winslow Accord had no quarrel with them. To their credit, they had no idea we were down there. Had they known. Well, I'm not sure things would have gone any differently. The Immortals had worried for years about another outbreak. This was the final straw, and contamination was a risk they weren't willing to take. They blew the supports and let the ocean flood the building. We needed to haul ass and get the hell out of there.
Thank you.
We needed to get out of there before the whole building collapsed. Hendrix had an idea. Flood the lab and let the water pressure jettison us out. Our lungs could take it. He just needed time to open the door.
Thank you.
And what happened then?
We got through it. We survived. Taylor's team was making their way out of Singapore. But we weren't giving up that easy. We still had a chance to catch up before the quarantine zone collapsed entirely. We couldn't make sense of what they'd done. Their motivations, their actions. There was no way to explain it. At least not yet. To figure that out, we needed them. And we also needed to get the hell out of Singapore. That was the day everything changed. That was the beginning. All right, Salim. Now tell me why. How do I if I'm dead?
Your body is dead, but your mind remains alive. I'm connected through your direct neural interface in your subconscious. To save humanity, you must open the portal. With your body gone, this is to train your mind.
Train my mind?
Relive the events preceding your last. Only then can you then.
This... Now this is insane.
Let me show you. Think back to when you first met Taylor. Think back to 2065, Dylan.
I'm heading toward downtown Zurich. Commander John Taylor. The first dead killer. The definition of determination. I was a rookie then. Fresh blood. There weren't many of us. There were more rumors about our division than actual recruits. They said we were engineered to be immune to 6115. That we couldn't get infected.
This was your first mission?
Yes. 5 years after the outbreak, most cities had at least one containment zone. But Zurich managed to stay outbreak-free. Now someone wanted to change that. Wait, this feels wrong. This can't be right. This can't be real. How are you doing this?
I am not doing anything. This is your mind. I'm the passenger, you're the pilot. But tell me, do you remember the train exploding?
No! Stop! Make it stop! Dr. Salim, what's happening? What's going on?
You must be calm. This is your memory, and you dictate the truth. But your mind can play tricks on you. It can deceive you. And it can lie. This never happened. But it nearly did. You and Taylor stopped it.
How can I see something that never happened? What the hell am I seeing? And why does it feel so damn real?
The human mind is fragile. Easily swayed by an incorrect recounting of events. This was one outcome your mind feared. Start from the beginning and take me through the mission. Once we organize everything correctly, we'll be able to find the truth. Tell me about the raid.
The raid. There was a Qatarist terrorist collective. They were planning something big. But they knew we were coming.
Stop. Don't rush through. Let us start with who was with you. You were not alone, after all.
Taylor. He told me they'd received a tip about the Qatarists. These undead sympathizers had sprung up around the globe in the years following the outbreak. They believed the undead were the next step in human evolution. To become undead was to live. The dead should inherit the Earth. Crazy, right?
Was it only Taylor? Was there anyone else?
Sebastian Diaz.
The man we saw at Coalescence, who would disable the undead defenses.
Back then, he was Taylor's second in command. He would take point on the raid. Hostile encounters were expected with the undead. But that didn't seem to bother him. They were so relaxed. The dead threatened Zurich. They were fearless. didn't take away our own fears. If I was gonna learn my shit, it would be on the job. This mission was my training. For him, it was just another day in the life. Business as usual. And business was booming. What are these drops I keep seeing? I saw them in Coalescence, too.
It is your mind trying to help you through your memories. Weapons, abilities, powers. Use them, Adon, but they may offer you a temporary advantage. Where did the Ars take you next?
You still have to get to the factory entrance. We still have to get to the factory entrance. We still have to get to the factory entrance. The entrance was locked. We had to destroy a generator to get it open. That was around the corner, with more dead standing in our way. I had an arsenal in front of me, but Diaz made it clear. He told me to run point on the ground. He was curious to see me think on my feet.
In a way, he was acting as your training.
Diaz wanted me to earn the name Dead Killer. And there's really only one way you can do that. I had support that day, but when you're out there in the real world, you're on your own. No backup, no reinforcements. Just you and the undead. I'd show him I was worthy of the name. The Cotardis base of operations was just ahead. Once we were inside, we'd be able to figure out what they were planning.
Fail! Salim, what's happening? I can't...
Stay with me. Come back to my voice.
I can't. I don't understand.
Tell me what happened.
I saw robots, and they were ripping me apart. What's happening to me? What was I seeing?
It is a lapse. Your mind is wandering into the unknown. Your subconscious finding fears, dreams, doubts. Stay with me. Stay with my voice. You're still in the factory. You were about to make a discovery.
Wait. Yes, there was a console ahead. Diaz told me to interface to get access to their network. We had to find out what they were planning.
Had you ever extracted information with your DNI before?
No. Nothing can really prepare you for it. The flood of data, endless streams of infinite information. It's instantaneous, and it's an eternity.
What did it show you?
The Cotardas had a contact, an inside man at Coalescence World Headquarters in Zurich. We had his address, ID number, security details, the last of which was most telling. He had extensive security clearance at Coalescence. Specifically, he had access to 6115, the virus.
Then let us do just that. Let us find him. Take me to his apartment.
We were ready to breach, but it didn't go as planned. He was ready. I had to get after him. Our mark was going to release 6115 into the surrounding area.
Remember, walk before you run. You weren't alone. Who else was there? Taylor?
Taylor. Yes, he discovered our mark had just unleashed the virus into Old Town, turning civilians into the living dead. But Taylor didn't lead that day. No, he had Overwatch. He was our eyes in the sky. Sarah Hall, however... Sarah Hall, the team's intelligence expert, was with me. She had point. She found our mark. Apparently his supply of 6115 was 10 times what we initially believed. Enough to turn all of Zurich into a city of the dead. Hall had been with Taylor as long as Diaz. He practically raised her, trained her. He made her. With Taylor in the sky, Hall was our feet on the ground. She didn't have as much patience for fresh blood as Diaz. She was direct and focused. And right now, she was about to give me a lesson in target acquirement. This guy didn't mess around. He had DNI just like us. He was hijacking any robotics he could, sending them after us.
What happened when you caught him?
Our mark was bleeding out after that fall through the ceiling. Time wasn't on our side, and we needed information.
So what did you do?
I would do what Hendrix did in Coalescence. I had to interface with him, extract the information from his memories.
You make it sound cold. You would be diving into this man's mind. A dangerous task. A terminal task.
I know, but you have to make it cold. Detach yourself from the person. It was our first time performing this sort of interface, and Hall wanted to get that point across above all else. It's nothing personal because there is no person. They're not humans. They're data banks for pilfering.
Even though it would kill him.
Even though. It's ironic, really.
Ironic?
Hall teaching me how to raid a person's mind. It wouldn't be long before. Well, we know what happens to Hall. What I do to Hall. But we do what we have to do. This was the world we made. If we don't do it, if we can't sacrifice the individual, how do we protect everyone else?
That is a heavy burden to press upon the individual.
If not us, then who? This was what it was about. Being part of an undead extermination team. Being a dead killer. It's about making that sacrifice. Making the ultimate sacrifice.
What did you find? What secrets did your databank have to share?
The Cotardus group had set up shop deep in the subways. Whatever they were planning, the answers were there.
Information that would stop the bomb. Save millions of lives. The greater good.
Yeah. The greater good. Taylor joined us. If we were going to move on the subway, we had to act fast. The attack, whatever it was imminent.
And your mark? What happened to him after your interface?
He was gone. Dead. The tunnels. We tracked down the Cotardus operations, and they were putting up a good fight.
Who joined you in the tunnels?
Taylor oversaw the operation, but the lead on this was Peter Moretti, the last of Taylor's team, an explosives expert. He was the guy you wanted when you needed to blow shit up. He was damn good at blowing shit up, which made him perfect for the fight ahead. Fearing discovery, the Cotardus Collective had an armada of undead and patrolling robotics guarding the facility. I won't lie, it's strange seeing Moretti like this, knowing what happens next. He was crucial to finding Taylor, to finding Deimos.
You mean the refineries in Cairo?
He had a pivotal part to play. He just didn't know it yet. What he knew then was the way to the hideout. He took point.
Yeah!
down!